Intimate partner violence and sexual violence is a major public health problem and a human rights violation. This causes long and short-term mental health problems, sexual problems, reproductive problems, not to mention a variety of others. 15 to 71% of women have identified themselves as being a victim of abuse, be it sexual or physical, and have been a victim of this at least once in their life. But what happens when it happens to the men? Let's go and ask some people on campus and see what they have to say. Warren.
Yes?
How many people do you think suffer abuse, be it sexual, physical, mental or emotional?
Is that a percentage, maybe?
Percentage or a number, as you wish.
70% of the human Maltese population, maybe.
The Maltese population. Do you think that's mainly men or women? As the victims?
I think it would be the majority women, but I do believe that there is a substantial number of men as well.
So you appreciate that men can actually be a victim of physical abuse, mental, emotional?
Of course. Abuse is not a one gender issue, it's a whole gender issue, so both men and women can be affected by it, and just because there's a stereotype that men have to be tough and strong about it, it's not quite true when you see the domestic abuse involved in it.
Okay then, and how did you come across this information?
Mostly through the internet. There are usually videos that highlight usually the physical abuse of women, but then when they would put the physical abuse on men, people would tend to just shove it away and think that the woman is finally taking her rightful place and showing the man who's boss. And basically I just found it disgusting to see the double standards that were being shown.
Absolutely. And how many men do you think suffer from violence of some description?
How many men? To be honest, I don't know as a number, but I do think it is quite a lot. Most of them would probably go unreported, and men are just too shy to speak about it. It's almost like something that people don't hear about mostly. Whenever you think of domestic abuse, it's always a woman. But when a man speaks up, they will think, oh, you're just being soft.
Do you think that if men want to report this sort of thing, that they feel emasculated by doing so? Do you think that's the problem?
I think, yes, they might feel emasculated or that they're not standing up to what they are as men. But I think it's silly. An abuse affects everyone. So I believe if you're a man and you're being abused, you should report it, even though it's a hard thing to do. But I would find it personally difficult myself.
Of course.
Because, as I said, like, there's always a stereotype and people are going to judge. And so once I would feel it's slightly emasculated, but I think it would be better to do that and forget what people say about it.
Abuse, i.e. sexual, physical, mental or emotional?
Do you mean specifically on this island?
Preferably Malta, yeah.
And you want a number?
Number, estimation. Percentage, how many you perceive there to be?
I've been hearing various numbers thrown around before. I'm thinking around 10-20%, because many of them are probably unreported as well.
Of course.
Reported would probably be such a low value, like 1-2%, like previous people have said. But I think 20%, 25%, probably higher sounds about right, because it's not reported. Like, it's, yeah.
Okay then, and as a foreigner's perspective, how do you perceive the domestic abuse to be? Do you think it's well handled? Do you think it's reported?
No.
Probably in the media?
I don't think it's well handled. I had a bad experience of trying to call APOCH. They're the ones that are supposed to help with taking care of these situations if women find themselves in trouble with their spouses or their partners. Couldn't get through, tried calling, kept being put on hold, line went through different people, it just took ages to get through to anyone, and I didn't manage to get through to anyone, like, just kept hanging up each time. And then the police come. I've had to call the police once. Woman leaves. I don't know what happens exactly. She just comes back to him. Like, that's what happened in that particular case. I'm sure there are situations where things have improved and the man might have gotten anger management classes or something.
Okay.
But Yeah, I don't think it's handled very well. It's a taboo subject that
of course
people don't want to discuss. If they know it happens, it's they keep hush hush about it.
Absolutely, everything behind closed doors stay there.
Yeah, exactly. It's private. Why would you want your private affairs to be known by everyone?
Yeah. Okay, so do you think a man can be a victim of domestic abuse?
Yes, of course. I've seen it happen as well.
Okay.
Not personally.
No. But you have had some experience.
Yeah. It's not pretty because people just ignore it. They're like, oh, look at that tough woman trying to man up against her man.
You think a woman, if a woman's abusive, she's being assertive rather than actually being classed as abusive. But for a man, it's the opposite.
It's again with the stereotypes as well. People see, like, with those kind of situations, that people think, oh, the man should be more manly and not let his girlfriend or whoever take over.
Yeah.
Per year? How many?
How many? As in how what percentage of the population?
What percentage of the population? Well, for Malta, I guess 2%, 2 to 5.
2 to 5% of the population of Malta.
Yes.
Okay, then. What makes you think that?
Oh, everything put together, I don't know. I mean, so there's different forms of abuse, different forms of violence. I don't know how people classify it legally, but I guess if you count all the things that are actually, all the cases that are studied, that actually reach the police, that sort of thing, together with those that don't reach the police, I think that would add up to 2%, actually. Maybe not 5, but 2, I think.
2%. Okay, then. And do you think a man could be a victim of abuse?
Yes, of course. Definitely. I mean, anyone can be a victim of abuse.
So, how many people suffer from abuse, be it sexual, physical, mental, or emotional? Your estimate.
As in
percentage of the population, or...
Maybe 10%.
10%. In total. Okay then. And do you think that a man can be a victim of domestic abuse?
Yes.
You think it's...
Yes.
You think it can happen? How much do you think?
I think it's less than I think females, but I think it can.
It can happen.
It can.
Do you think it's something that's reported very often?
No, not really.
Why do you think that is?
I think in generally men are more, how do you say, not proud, but, you know, sort of, they wouldn't say that they're being sort of abused.
Everyone.
Everyone, so 100% basically.
Yeah.
Okay.
At some point, some different varying levels of intensity, but yeah.
Okay, and Aito, what do you think?
I think I'm going to agree with my mate. I think everyone, we always suffer from something, and in the end you cannot control if it's abuse or not, you cannot. It's a very, very narrow line. You trespass from normal situation to something that could make abuse. And it just depends mostly on the point of view of somebody. That.
So you go for 100% as well?
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Interesting. Okay, then. And do you think a man can be a victim of domestic abuse?
Definitely.
Yeah.
And how much do you think? What percentage?
Oh, I'm afraid I cannot. I mean, the thing is, domestic abuse is very different when you have people with different power positions.
Okay.
So men are usually more capable of causing more harm,
yes,
especially physical harm,
uh-huh,
to women. So in that sense, men would have less, would find less abuse than women.
Okay.
But how many? I don't know. I would, from my point of view, I would say zero because I don't know any case,
uh-huh,
personally, but I know that it exists. So.
Okay, so you think quite a low number, but you can't. How about you, Aito?
I don't know if you can. I think it's very hard to report abuse on men because mostly it's men abuse of women in straight relationships. So, if you take it to gay relationships where it's both men, then I guess there's always one who's gonna be dominant, one's gonna be the passive.
So
I guess if it comes to the gay part, it's gonna be basically half of them.
Okay.
Because there's always one who is.
And what about if the violence is actually caused by a woman?
I also know some couples where the woman is actually more physically stronger than the man.
Oh, okay.
And that results in what some people would might see as abuse, but they justify it as normal because it's part of their relation. But
and I think that the mentality kind of shifts towards seeing domestic violence is more about the suffering of women, when in reality, I'm mistaken, about a third, if not more, is domestic violence on even men.
Okay, even if it's perpetrated by a woman, not necessarily in homosexual
relationships. Yeah, I think it works both ways.
Okay, and what type of violence do you think that women generally will inflict on their partner?
Women would inflict on their partner?
You think they're more prone to one type or another, or?
I wouldn't think so. I'm sure that both physical and verbal domestic violence is common in both sexes.
Okay.
I wouldn't say that one is more prone to the other.
Okay then. And roughly how many or what proportion of cases do you think are men?
Out of 100%, probably I would say about 40%, I think, would be men.
So 100% of the cases reported, 40%.